That is the time he materialized the Jyotirling. And the Jyotirling has the Jyoti inside and the different colors. So he came, he said, Pakoda, can you see the Jyoti? I said, now I can see the Jyoti. Then he said, see the color changing. I said, yes, it is yellow. Then it's changing to blue, it's changing to green. He says, this is creation. Creation every second is changing. You know, you were supposed to die. I said, yeah, I knew from childhood that I'll die at the age of 50. Then he said, no. When Yama came to take you, Satya Sai told him that take her wealth and leave her for me. And then he told me that from now onwards, you will be leading a life which he has planned for you. And let me tell you, it's not me talking. It is he who is talking. Because as I said, I'm not a speaker. I don't know how to speak. And I'm still scared of this. I am not very happy with this, but I leave it to him. Whatever he decides has to come out, comes out. My most humble pranams to Swami, respected elders, and brothers and sisters of the Sai family, and my salutations to Dr. K.K. Mistry for coming over here. And I really respect him because he was my father's very close friend. Dear brothers and sisters, my life starts from the age of 4 when I first came to Swami. I was a handicapped child who had polio and paralysis. Having polio is one thing, but having paralysis is a very major issue. And I was not able to do anything. I could not walk, I could not move. It was in my uncle's house at Malabar Hill that I first saw Swami. I was sitting in the corner in the hall and I was looking at him. And at that tender age of 4, I took a liking to Swami. Swami saw me, met me, and spoke to my parents. But we went just as to see a Guruji. Then it so happened that my father had called doctors from Switzerland to get me operated. And I did not want to be operated without taking the blessings. At that age, I used to call Swami Baba Guru. I said, I want to go to Baba Guru and take his blessings. So my mother, she told my father that I have to take her to Puttaparthi. Those days, it was not easy going to Parthi. We had to go via Bukkapatnam and go in the cart. And a fully handicapped child, my mother, I have full gratitude to her for having taken me to Swami. When we went to Parthi, Swami welcomed us and he told my mother, she is not going to be operated. So my mother said no. And my father was in those days like a Britisher, because he was, you know, he did not believe so much in saints and all that. And he said, I have called the doctor from Switzerland. But Swami asked my mother to go to the post office and make a call and say that no, we are not coming, let the doctor go. Till the doctor did not leave India, I was in Parthi with Swami. After he left, Swami said, now you can go. When we reached in Bombay, my father was fuming and he was very, very upset that why, what is this? I've done so much. Then Swami said that no. He told my mother, if I would have been operated, first it would have been the right leg, then the right hand, then the left leg, and I would be left only with the trunk of the body. So he said no. Then he told my father that see, she was my very good devotee in the Shirdi Sai avatar. I wanted her back. So this was an excuse. So my father then realized and he said, okay. And from that day, the life started with Swami. In those days, we used to go to the... Actually, I have to be very grateful and thankful to my servant, Sri Sharma, who, when those days we used to go to Chitravati, Swami used to give his talks on Chitravati. My servant took me and threw me on Swami's feet. And a child of four being thrown on Swami's feet on the sand would but naturally cry. So Swamiji immediately shouted at my servant and said, "What is this? Why have you thrown her on the floor?" So he said, "Swami, it's better she dies. See, being a girl, being unable to move, I was a big hindrance to the family as well as to the society. So he said, it's better that she dies at your lotus feet." And Swami immediately materialized sweets from the sand and he gave me the sweets and said, "Stop crying." And he picked me up and took me in his lap. And till date, I'm still sitting on his lap. I have not got down yet because he confirmed this to some foreigners in an interview that she's still with me on my palm. She has not yet come down. He teaches me all through life as a child. And I'm so happy to be his child. Then it so happened that if you all remember the old devotees, on the right hand side of Prashanti Mandiram is the dining hall where Swami used to have his dinner. So we used to go up there and Swami used to keep me behind and used to feed me and every day put vibhuti and massage my leg. If it was not for the divine hands, I don't think I would be standing and sitting in front of you all today. It was just his love, his care, the doctor of doctors who really took care of me. Every day I was busy having food from Swami and he told me, "You keep walking, keep falling, the blood of yours will purify Puttaparthi." I used to get a lot of hurt because I could not walk, but I never stopped. I was having a lot and lot of love and faith for Swami. Then my mother told my father that now you must come to Parthi and thank him because your daughter without an operation is at least walking. So my father came down to Parthi and he was a real Englishman with a pipe in his hand and, you know, coat and everything. And in those days we didn't have bathrooms and all, you know, so my mother had to take the can and go with him for the toilet. He says, "What is this? What a village. Where have you brought me?" But he had to come and thank Swami for curing me. So he came, he thanked Swami. And that is the time when Swami told him about our relationship of the previous birth. Then my father was very happy and that transformed him. It is very, very surprising that he changed a complete different person. And I think all of you all know Mr. Jawa, my father. He was the one who used to bring Swami to Bombay and take him back. Mr. Jawa and Dr. K.K. Mistry were the two people who were in charge of always arranging the flight and everything for Swami to come and go to Bombay. Bombay was Swami's home. It was in 1967 when the foundation of Dharam Kshetra was done. And every day or alternate day, my father used to come to see the construction and I used to come with him on the weekends. So like every stone and everything put in Dharam Kshetra, I have seen with my own eyes. I was just a kid of 13 years old. I just entered my teens. Then it happened to be Dharam Kshetra inauguration and I was selected as one of the seven fairies to take Swami around Dharam Kshetra. So today I feel so blessed that his fairy has come back home. We took Swami around Dharam Kshetra, showed him Satyadeep and everything. Then he told us, "Come up to my room, you have to leave me to my room." So we went up to his room, we left him to his room and he gave us sweets and he sent. I never expected that after so many years, you can say actually this is the starting, May you will be starting the 50th golden anniversary of Dharam Kshetra. And I feel so blessed to be here today talking to you all about my experience, his love and his leela. Then as I grew up, my principal of my convent school was very, very nice. She said, "Rani, so long as you're getting all right, I give you leave to go to him." Till the fourth standard, my classroom was always kept on the ground floor because it was a bit difficult for me to climb steps. And the principal was very good. Being a Catholic nun, she was very, very cooperative and she always gave me leave to go to Swami. And I used to go every time to Swami. It so happens that Puttaparthi was going to be changed into the new Puttaparthi, which you all are seeing. So 9 years, Swami did not allow us to come to Parthi because it was, and those days we were staying near the post office and next to Uncle Kasturi's house. So I was a very naughty child because I had access to Swami, so I was very, very naughty. And it so happened that because the Puttaparthi was being renovated, we had to go to Bangalore. So my full childhood has gone living in Vrindavan. I never took my parents as my parents because I never stayed with them. First, we used to go on the weekends to Vrindavan. Swami used to say, Java, whenever there is holiday, send my brother Omi and myself to Bangalore. And those days, the flight ticket was only 125 rupees return ticket. So it was very, very cheap. So first it was, we were coming for weekends and vacations to Bangalore. Then it happened that we started coming for long weekends. And I stayed like everything in my life. In the 8th standard, we have to select, should we take French or Sanskrit? So Swami said, no, don't take Sanskrit. You were a Sanskrit scholar in your previous birth, take French. But he had planned everything. I can tell you today when I see the whole thing, it was all his planning. So he told me, you take French. Okay, I took French. I was very fond of maths. No, don't take higher maths. You don't need it. Then I said, Swami, what do I take? He says, take elementary maths. I said, that is baby's play. No, you take elementary maths. It is very good. Okay, elementary maths. We all take physics, chemistry. No, don't take physics, chemistry. It's not going to come in your use only. Take physiology, hygiene. Okay, I took physiology, hygiene. Then I finished my schooling. And right from dressing, I started with, that skirt, blouse, then half sari. My first sari he gave me, which he brought from Africa. He said, now wear a sari. And then he said, sari looks nice. So at the tender, when I'm still in school, I'm wearing saris. I never got a chance to wear salwar kameez or anything. It was just saris. And he was very particular. Everything he used to be, like, he was very possessive. He didn't allow me to have friends. He used to tell my father, Java, that friend of hers is not good. That friend is not good. And he knew my friends by their names. And he said, that one is not good. He says, I am your friend. Why do you need anyone? So we were the best of friends. And what was my job when I was in Vrindavan? Sitting outside his room and driving away the monkeys. This was a job he gave me. And then what he used to do when he used to get up from his sleep, come and frighten me from behind so that I stumble on the steps. I used to say, Swami, what is this? He says, no, I have come to tell you I have got up. So that's how I spent. It was like we were always in playing. It was always, I never knew Swami as God. Let me be very, very frank. I never knew that he was God or anything. I only knew him as my friend. Whatever I wanted, whatever, my father and mother could not tell me anything. If they told me anything, it was very simple. One message to Swami and they used to get into trouble. So they never told me anything. Whatever I wanted to do, I could do. And only to write my exams, he used to send me back to Bombay. I never studied. I used to just come back, write my papers, and I somehow or the other passed. Then it so happened that, what was our job, my brother and me, during Swami's interview to press his feet. We were only pressing his feet and pressing his feet, pulling his legs, making that noise of the knuckles. So that was the job we had. So we used to listen to everyone's interviews, So I used to feel very sad. I said, Swami, that lady has come with so much of difficulties. Let her go smiling. Why are you making her cry? I didn't make her cry. She's crying. I said, Swami, you're shouting. Don't shout at them. Give them love. They've come to you for love. No, she told me, I didn't say anything. So then years passed only in doing Swami's path seva. Then when I became 16, 17, I told Swami, now I don't want interview. He says, why everyone wants interview? Why you don't want interview? I said, when we go out, people ask, what happened? What happened inside? What happened inside? I said, it's very embarrassing to talk, to tell anything. And Swami said, okay. I said, Swami, instead of interview, can I have interview? He said, sure. I said, I want you 24/7 with me. if I say anything, if I call you, I want you with me. And let me tell you, he helped me to practice interview, and I find him with me 24/7. No more interviews, it was an interview. And I tell all of y'all, please, Swami is in you. Please, he's talking to you. Just hear him. Take out the dust which is formed on your soul and hear him. He's calling y'all, but y'all are not hearing, y'all are giving a deaf ear. You will hear him talking and guiding you. He held my hand in my life, and till date he has not left my hand at all. This was my childhood, and I had the good fortune of really enjoying with Swami. In 68, when Swami went to Africa, he left Ishwarama in our house. Now we are all sisters. So Ishwarama was so happy to see that we are going to school and college and all that. And she was really surprised that, oh, girls are educated in the cities. So she said, I have to tell Swami that there should be education for girls. And when Swami came back from when Swami was in Africa, I was very lucky because he used to call to speak to Amma, and he had to first speak to me, and then the phone went to his mother. Without speaking to me, I never gave the phone to the mother. So I had many opportunities to speak with Swami on the phone, because as I said, he was my friend and I was very naughty. So there was no way that, you know, it could be avoided. So when I still remember when Swami came back from Africa, in the car, Amma told Swami, Swami, Java's daughters are all studying. I want that our children in Anandpur and all ladies should be educated. Then Swami said, Java, you go to Anandpur, look out for a land, and I will build the Anandpur College. And that's how Anandpur College came into existence. But he never allowed me to go to Anandpur. He said, you are not studying in Anandpur. I said, Swami, why? Ladies' college? No. Java will come every month to see you. There will be a lot of disturbance. You stay. Because why? It is not Java. Because I was going to Swami. If I go to Anandpur, I can't go to Swami because they are very strict. But if I'm studying in Bombay, I can keep going to Swami. And it was during my college only that Indian Airlines took out a pass for students, that they don't have to, you know, take permission every time. We had an ID card, which we had to, in the beginning of the year, get it signed by our principal. So that was a passport, like, you know, I had that ID card. So every week I could go to Puttaparthi and enjoy myself and all. Now, this was the full childhood. Then started from 1971 onwards, you know, I started getting interested in all the spiritual works and everything. My thirst was there. I wanted to know what is God. Not knowing that I am playing with God, I wanted to know what is God, what is the Ramayana, what is the Mahabharata. So I started reading books, and Swami started giving me a lot of books to read and all that. Those years I read. 72, he said, Rani, you come for summer course. So I went for the summer course. Now, I cannot write curve writing because of my polio. My writing is print. I cannot write curve. So I was very busy because it was first time I was exposed to spiritualism. So I was writing in print but fast. So Swami would come and, you know, disturb me. He wanted to distract me. And I used to have fights with him. I said, don't distract me, because if I miss out one line, then finish. So then he used to just stand next to me, and I used to write. I wrote everything in the books. Then I started getting deep into it. I stood first in the summer course. So Swami came up to me and said, Rani, you are my child. I would like to give the prize to someone else. I said, sure, Swami, I don't mind. I'll give you personal prize. I said, sure, Swami, no problem. I don't mind. And I don't like to go to the stage and everything. So the prize was given to, I think, Rohini Gupta from Bombay. She stays at Nariman Point. She got the prize, I still remember. And I just relaxed. It so happens in June we have a factory anniversary. Swami came. Upstairs he didn't sign the photo. Then he comes to the house to have his food and everything. So till mommy was preparing the food, daddy and I were keeping him busy talking to him. So then Swami asked, Rani, he calls me Pakoda. Swami's name for me was Pakoda because I was very fat. So Swami says, Pakoda, give me the photo, I'll sign. So he signed with love and blessings. He said, this is your prize. I said, good, Swami. He signed with love and blessings to me. And then he asked my father, Jama, what is her name? Because I know her as Pakoda. So my father said, Rani Lakshman Java. So Swami said, Rani Lakshman Java? No, no, no. It doesn't sound good. So he wrote behind, to Miss Rani Java. He showed me more than a dozen boys to get married. But in 72, he decided that I had to remain a Miss. He wrote it as Miss. Until date, I am a Miss only. I did not change my surname. So he plans everything. He's a real director who plans everything. My father felt very bad because I started calling myself as Miss Rani Java. So Swami called me as Miss Rani Java. So my father said, how can you do that? You have to continue with Rani Lakshman Java. I said, fine. The day my father left, from that day I became Miss Rani Java. I told him, till you live, I'll be Rani Lakshman Java. The day you leave, it will be Rani Java. Because he has given me the name. So I will accept that name and not the name which you have given me. So I now sign as Rani Java. Every way, my bank accounts, everything is Miss Rani Java. Then it so happened that education, I was studying and everything. He told, I did my BCom. Then after that, he told me, now you do your MCom. I did my MCom. And I didn't want to study in our Sindhi community. Girls don't study that much, you know. He said, no, you study. He made me do my systems management from Jannalal Bajaj. Then he told me, do finance manage, then income tax manage. Then one fine day in 84, he says, I was selected by USA, by Institute Arthur the Little, which was a part of Harvard's and MIT. So Swami was very happy. He said, see, you didn't apply, they selected you, so you must go. I said, Swami, I can't stay without you. How can I go? No, no, don't worry, I'm there with you. I'll arrange everything. He called one devotee from Boston and told her, you have to take care of Rani, because I was very spoiled by Swami. So he says, you have to take care of her and all that and keep her in your house. I don't want her to be in the hostel. I went there. In 2 months, I was like a fish without water. I could not stay without Swami. I left Harvard's and I came straight back to India. I told Swami, I had a ticket of 4 months. So I told my father, Dad, my ticket is going to expire. Can I just come and see Swami? So he said, okay, you come to India. I came, I went to Parthi Strait. I said, Swami, where have you put me? In 84, there were no Indians in USA. Very few Indians. Now, though, you turn here, you turn there, you have Indians. But that time, you didn't have Indians, you know. I said, Swami, I really fish. I'm like a fish, you know, over there without water. Then he said, okay. He told my dad that she can't stay without me. Let her educate in India. He asked me, go to Bombay and do computers. My father and I were looking at his face. We are ice cream industrial people. I am in the ice cream industry. What have I to do with computers? So we asked Swami, Swami, computers, what have I to do? No. It's going to be the in thing. Learn computers. So then I went for computers. I did my diploma in computers. Because in the US, I did do on the mainframes, I learned about computers and psychology, because I was troubling Chitra with a lot for the vocational guidance. So I thought, let me do psychology also when I'm doing these courses. Then I left everything and I settled back in India and I did my this course. Now having, if you all remember, the old people will remember, the students had come from Bangalore and they did Bhaja Govindam in Shanmukhanand Hall. That play had really hit my heart. It hit me so badly. So then Swami told me, you loved it. I said, yes, Swami. He said, I'll make you experience it. That was the reason why he made me take degree after degree, degree after degree, degree after degree. He made me realize that all this degree you take, but ultimately you will be doing his work. And then I realized, I said, oh, my dream he fulfilled. It so happened that during those days, you know, once Swami thought that I must reduce, I must become thin. So he told me, Pakoda, you come walking from, we stay 2 kilometers away from Vrindavan. You come walking from Vrindavan, I'll wait for you at the gate with 2 glucose biscuits. And you have that for breakfast. So I said, okay, Swami. So I used to come, Swami used to give me 2 glucose biscuits. then he'll go out for darshan. And after Swami went out for darshan, I used to go inside. Now, I was a pet of Ishwaramma, Venkatma and Parvati Ma. They loved me, like I feel I am one with that family. So they say, what nonsense, what is Swami doing? How can you survive on two biscuits? Ishwaramma will say, see, I have made lovely dosas for you. Lovely dosas, why don't you eat dosas and idli? I used to happily sit on her lap and have dosas and idli. Then Venkatma would come, she say, no, today Mrs. Ratanlal has brought puri bhaji. I used to eat puri bhaji. Then Parvati Amma would come and say, you know, today Mrs. Poonam Chand has made nice parathas. I used to eat paratha. One day Swami came back from his darshan and he came straight into the dining hall in Vrindavan. He saw that I am sitting there, mother, sisters, all there, and everyone is busy feeding me, you know. He started shouting. He says, no wonder, I am standing at the gate with two biscuits and she's not reducing. And here you all are all feeding her. So that was, you know, that was a love between us, you know. I said, Swami, what do I do? So with so much love, I can't tell no. One is your mother, one is your sister, I can't say no. So he says, never mind, I give up and you also give up. We are not going to reduce. So I am as it is, like this only. I have not reduced. But when in 2000, I started writing books. There was some, I had made a Sai series where I compare each god with Swami. Every god with Swami. So I had done five of them. So I had practiced it by keeping the fast. So that time I had reduced. So in Vrindavan, he came to me. Are, my pakoda, why have you become a chapati? So I said, Swami, you know it. So he says, nay. I said, Swami, you know, I'm trying all. Because if I have to tell someone that if you do this ritual, you are going to get success, I have to do it on myself. So I did a research. So I said, Swami, you know, I was doing a research for that reason. Okay, Bangaru. But I managed to write only five. I have 15, but I published five of them. I did not publish any more. That too, Swami asked me to do it because in the, what you say, Shirdi Avatar, I was supposed to write a book. I did not write. So Swami asked me, just complete that part of it. So I said, okay, I did it. Then I asked him, Swami, 50 glorious years with you is over. Can I write a book on you? No. Ours is a personal experience. You don't have to write it. You don't have to share it. So my father also, before he passed away, I asked him, I said, Dad, let me write the book. Because the name, everything was fixed in the mind. He said, no, Swami has not given you permission, so don't write. So then I gave up the idea of writing. Just before Swami's Mahasamadhi, in 2000, Swami decided that I have to go around the world in 90 days. So he sat and he made my itinerary for, I think he must have made and cancelled more than a dozen times. I did not know exactly, and imagine going all alone around the world. So I told Swami, why will I go alone? Let me have some company. I'm there. And he was making my itinerary. He kept 10 days in Switzerland. Why? He said, I used to go to the Himalayas every year. I had a lot of affinity to the Himalayas and I felt that I can feel God over there. So once actually Swami did not want me to go in the beginning. So he said, no, why you want to go? I wanted to go to Badrinath. Our family had that problem that none of the family members can reach Badrinath. My grandmother wanted to go. We went up to Joshimath and they tell us that, no, you take vaccination and all. So we had to come back. And next month she passed away. So then I went to Swami. I said, Swami, granny wanted to go to Badrinath. I have to go. So he said, it is taboo for your family. Why do you want to go? So I just told him one question. Why did you take Ishwaramma and go? You answer me that, I will answer you that. So then he kept quiet. He said, okay, I cannot tell you anything, you go. But he took care of me. I nearly had a lot of experience because it was end of October when the mandir was closing and I was all alone. The alone idiot going from Bombay to Patti to have, Bombay to Badrinath to have darshan. I was all alone. And then the bus leaves me up to Rishikesh and he says, madam, there's no one for Badrinath. now you have to come back to Delhi. I said, don't be a fool. I've come all the way here to go to Badrinath. Why will I go back to Bombay? So he says, no, you have to go back because there is no way you can go. The temple is closing because there's heavy snow and military has already started going. I said, I'm sorry. Then at the hotel, the manager came and he said, there are two couples who want to go and I'm arranging for a car for them to go. So I said, okay. Now the couples had a doubt, a girl, single girl coming from Bombay. So the husband-wives were getting a bit jittery. And I too was jittery that I'm going with two unknown couples to Badrinath. But I had Swami with me, so I decided, okay, I am going with them. We went and it was such a pleasant thing because it turned out that one of the brothers was the director of Shipping Corporation of India. And my brother-in-law was over there as an assistant. So he said, oh, are you Bhatia's sister-in-law? I said, yes. They said, we don't have daughters. So they took care of me. I cannot walk. I cannot walk on steps and all. So they held my hand and they took me all around Badrinath. And we went and had a dip in the kund and everything. They took so much care of me. So it is Swami who arranges everything. If we have the faith and the determination, He is there to take you. But if you think, nahi, it's all right. Oh, it's all right. No, then it is all right only. It's nothing is all right. But when you are determined that, no, I have to do it, you have to do it. I went to every nook and corner of pilgrimage places in India because I wanted to feel the vibrations of all what has happened. So Swami could never say no to me. It so happened Swami was going from Dharam Kshetra back to Bangalore and my father and my mother, I think that time all husband wives of the Samiti were going together with Swami. So my mother said, ask Swami, because it was my desire to go to Kailash. Imagine with this leg, I wanted to go to Kailash. So he asked Swami, Swami, Rani wants to go to Kailash. Why? So Java said, Swami, you know, with Rani, there is no why. She wants to go. So then Swami thought and everything. He said, okay, let her go, but tell her not to do parikrama of Mount Kailash. But she can go. Mansuvar mein, she can do her puja. Fine. Then when I was to leave for Kailash, Uncle Indulal Shah, my father, they are bribing with me with cars and a better house to live in and all because they didn't want me to go to Kailash. As soon as we reached the airport, Bombay lights never go, but the lights went off. My father is saying, bad signal, don't go, don't go. And I had to make a will because they don't take you to Kailash without a will. So I took my father to the court. He says, I have not made my will. How can you take me to court? I said, come, because you are going to be the survivor, come to the court and you have to be my witness and I'm making my will. So then he came, then I gave my will and I got my ticket, I went. Now I had gone with Swami's blessings. But it was a tough trip. One day our car sunk in the river and with my weight it will sink more. So we had Chinese drivers. So he loved me like anything, the Chinese driver, because I was keeping my Shravan month fast and every day I was making my shivling and all that. So he said, no, you get out from the window. I said, are you crazy? I'll open the window, the water will all come into the car and then we all sunk. So he says, no, I can't allow you to sink. I said, no, but I'll have to take the other passengers also in with me. So then we waited, a truck came and we got saved and all. Now when we finished our yatra, then I didn't do the parikrama of Kailash. I went to the down part, I did the puja, everything over there. Then at Kailash, I made 108 shivlings. And I did not know I had put on the Tandav cassette. And there Shiva started doing the Tandav dance. And the Chinese, they came and said, close it, what are you doing? See, all clouds are come and Shiva has started the Tandava dance. I said, oh my Lord. So they put off that CD of mine and then I started praying. Then I started praying because very heavy snow came. And I was thinking, oh, all my friends are on the mountain, all my friends are there. One of my co-friends, his foot was frostbitten. And then I was only applying vibhuti every day. I said, Swami, please, his foot should not be amputated, because there was only amputation because he had got frostbite. I was praying and praying, and only vibhuti, that gentleman got saved. And actually they say Kailash is a one-way ticket, but we all came back safely. It so happened there was a landslide. Now a landslide, I cannot walk on uneven ground. I just cannot walk on uneven ground. And they said, now we have to cross this, we can't take the cars. I said, now what happens? You'll leave me. Anyhow, I told my parents, Alvita, that I may not come back. So I can stay here, y'all go. They said, nothing doing, we are going to take you along with us. So we managed to get one Sherpa to help me to hold my hand. And the other hand was held by my colleagues. Now they had children, they were married people. And as we were going, the stones, you know, they were falling down. Because I can't walk on uneven ground. I said, I will pull you down. You will also go with me, and you have small kids. Because I seen them, they had come to say farewell to their parents. So I was feeling very disturbed. So I was busy saying, Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram. Then a Sherpa comes with curly, curly hair. And he tells me, hold my hand. And it was a very, very tight grip. And he said, put your foot in my footprints. Exactly in my footprints you put and you walk. And so he held my hand, and in his footprints I put my foot, and you won't believe, I was the first person to cross over the path. When I reached, I was trembling. He went and he told that lady, make some adrak ka chai, because adrak chai is very good when you are shaking. So the lady made adrak chai, he put me in the bus and he told me, now you drink this hot tea. I drank the hot tea, I became all right. I went to pay the money for the tea. So the lady said, no, the money has already been paid. Then I said, where is the Sherpa? I have to give him money. He helped me to cross over. The Sherpa was gone. So as soon as I reached Kathmandu, I gave a call to my father. I said, Dad, please go to Swami in Vrindavan and tell him thank you. He is, you know, he saved me. Now, you know, I have a very slow tube light. It doesn't strike very fast that who else but Swami has come to cross me. So when my father went, he said, Swami, Rani said, thank you. She got saved. Java, what to do? She stands there and she says, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Ram. I had no other job. So I had to go and take her. So it was Swami who took me across from that landslide and put me in the bus. This was one incident when he came to my rescue. The second incident was in 2000, he asked me to go on this round the world trip. So I said, Swami, I don't know anyone in Switzerland. He says, I know, my friends, my devotees, you don't worry, you go, 10 days. I reached Paris, my bags are not there. Now why the bags were not there? Because I was going 90 days, I had a big suitcase. So we have to take a train from Paris airport and go to Paris station. So first of all, I can't walk. I had a trolley bag, I had that big bag, I had an overcoat, and those days I used to carry my laptop. So I had my laptop. Now how do I manage all this? And I had to change two trains to reach the main station to catch my train to Geneva. So Swami, I said, now what do I do? Those people told me, don't worry about your bag. And actually it was Swami who got the bag stuck down. In the conveyor, it was stuck down. He said, Madam, where are you staying? I said, I'm staying with Mr. Premji. Oh, we know him very well. We will bring the bag to your house tomorrow morning. You don't worry. I said, thank you. And an old lady was nicely, even in my young age, I was an old lady, walking with my trolley and my coat and everything. I took the train. In the plane, I met some French woman from Pondicherry. So they wrote for me and they told me how I see in the train. And imagine, this is after 84 when I went to the US. This was my first visit and all alone. So I was looking, now this station is going to come. I have to get down here and then take another train. Then I reached the main station. When I reached the main station, in front of my eyes, my train is going. I'm just looking at it, I did not know what to do. And again I started, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Sai Ram. I'm not asking the neighbor anything. I'm just going on saying, Sai Ram, Sai Ram, Swami, what happened? My train is gone. All of a sudden, with the curly hair, dark face, yellow coat, Swamiji comes. and still a tube light, not working. Swami comes, he says, you look lost. I said, yes, in front of my eyes, the train has gone. Okay, come, we'll go and see. He went and he saw the board. He says, no, now next train is in the morning. I said, morning, what will I do? Then we went to the manager there at the station and we told him that, can I sleep the night at the station? He says, no, you cannot stay in the station, you have to go. Hey, Paris and me going in a hotel and staying, not possible, impossible, I will not go. Then he said, okay, let me see. Then we called up my host. I said, what can I do alone at Paris hotel? So then after that, Swami saw the board. He said, there's one train which is not going. I was to go to Lausanne. He said, instead of Lausanne, Geneva is not very far. You can go to Geneva. In the meanwhile, I had only dollars. So he said, come, let us change some money for you. And those days, euros were not there. He said, I had to take French francs. So he got me some French francs. And he said, we did the phone call and everything. Then he called my host again and he said, there's a train going up to Geneva. Can you go and pick her up from there? By then my host had got a lot of firing from his wife. He said, yes, we'll go to Geneva and pick her up. Let her come to Geneva. So, okay, it was decided. When I went in the train, in my compartment, there was no one. He met the ticket collector. He said, sir, if I buy her ticket, this train will also go. She has a URL pass for the previous train. She missed it. So please let her go. So he said, okay, you can go. So he took me, he made me sit on the back seat and there was only a black in the compartment, no one else. Then I just sat and I was still scared and I'm only going on saying, Sairam, Sairam, Sairam. Then he told me, then I said, sir, you have spent money for me. So take this few francs and keep because you paid for the trolley, you paid for the phone. No, you keep it, it will come in handy. No, sir, my Guruji has told me this is my last birth. Where will I come back to give you the money? I'm telling this to Swami. So then I said, no, sir, I'm very, very sorry. So he said, no. Then he smiled and he went. Then he realized this one has still not understood. Then he comes back. He says, you have not eaten food. You left Bangalore. You had breakfast in Bombay. You had lunch in Delhi. So now you better eat. I have kept you near the pantry. And once, I'm a very scarecrow also. I'll sit means I'll sit. I will not look here, I'll not look there, I won't go. So he said, just get up and there is a pantry. Then he told me, don't take this salad because this salad has got meat in it. Take this salad and take this bread and take, because the other bread has got egg on it, don't take. Take this coke, have this and eat because you have not eaten. Then it struck me. I never spoke to this gentleman so much. I was only saying, Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram. From where did he know I had breakfast in Bombay, lunch in Delhi? Then it struck me, oh my Lord, this is Swami. So as soon as I reached, I went, I ate that. As soon as I reached, my host came. And they also came with food because they knew I had not eaten. So I said, Uncle, I don't know what happened. And I think it was Swami because he told me all about these things. So he said, Rani, 2 hours. Don't expect in Paris anyone to be with you. It is no one else but Swami. I said, oh my Lord, he carried all my things and everything. And he says, but you were not scared he will take away your laptop and all. I said, no, I felt quite comfortable with him. I allowed him to carry everything because I had to walk. So then I called up my father and I told my father. So my father immediately morning, he went to Vrindavan. He told Swami, like this happened. Swami said, Java, what to do? She was only going on saying, Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram. In front of her eyes, the train is going. She's not telling anyone. They could have stopped the train. But she's just looking how the door is closing because that was my first experience. And I suddenly see the door is closing. You think she's standing there and looking at the door closing, but she's not telling that she has to go. So then he said, I had to come to her. Then he told my father, you know what? She did not realize that it was me. And she gives me money, saying that you spent so much of money. And then I told her, no, you keep it. Then she's giving me my lecture that it is my last birth. So you please take this money. So Swami started laughing like anything. In Vrindavan, he's making fun of me. You know, he was really making fun of me. Then what had happened, because Swami had done the planning, no? So he asked that every day I have to give a call and report, like what my host is showing. And actually, I used to go to the Himalayas every year. So Swami told my father, she's going to the Himalayas every year, she may become a sage. So please see that she doesn't go to the Himalayas. So Swami said, Switzerland, plenty of snow. It's like Himalayas. You will like it. You go. I went to Switzerland, my first experience. Arey, where is the snow? I can't see any snow. I said, Swami, you cheated me. I said, this is not fair. I told my host, this is nonsense. Where is the snow? My Himalayas are better. And Swami told me, there's plenty of snow. That night, it snowed. And this is in the month of April. In April, it never snows in Switzerland. And like, in the morning, I got up. My host told me, come to the kitchen, see the mountains. Because you could see his house was on the lake. And from the mountains, you could see all the snow, fresh snow falling. Oh, I was so excited, you know, seeing fresh snow falling. Though India, I had seen Kashmir, Simla and everything. But Switzerland, because Swami compared it to the Himalayas, so I was very happy. And because I had to report to Swami, my host, who was not interested in me, took me north, south, east, west of Switzerland. He took me to every nook and corner. Like I can tell you, I have seen Switzerland. Even the people in Switzerland would have not seen that much, as much as I have seen. And I used to call up Swami I used to call up my father and he used to report to Swami. Then after 10 days, I'm supposed to go back. My luggage came. Then my host said that when Swami was so thoughtful about you not carrying the bag, Rani, you keep this bag here. We will come. When you come to Lausanne, we'll give you your bag. And they packed all Indian food. My trip to Europe for the whole 1 month, you will be surprised, I didn't have to eat pizzas and burgers and all. I was eating puri bhaji and yogurt. I was so fortunate because Swami knows I don't like all that stupid stuff. So my host packed up one full crate of yogurt and puri, aloo ki sabzi and thepla and everything possible. I got packed. Everyone used to get down and go to the pizza shop and buy pizzas, and I used to have my vegetarian food. Whoever was my friend, I was sharing with them. And then when I came back to Lausanne, again they gave me a full package of food. So my whole trip to Europe was on puri bhaji. And till date, my food in Europe is shuddha Indian khana. I get perfect dal, bhat, rotli, saag till date. And let me tell you, I stopped going to the Himalayas, but I started going to Switzerland. I've had 9 visits to Switzerland. Every alternate year, I go to Switzerland. Switzerland has now become like my second home. Now, I was not a speaker. When Swami had come to Bombay, he asked me to go for public speaking classes. I went, I came back. I said, Swami, not my cup of tea. He said, why? I said, that gentleman told me, stand in front of the mirror and talk. Am I mad to stand in front of the mirror and talk? At that age, you know, when you're in college, you will not accept all this. I said, no, it's not my cup of tea, and this mic frightens me. I cannot talk. So then Swami said, okay, one thing, Java doesn't talk, nor his daughter. So to tease me in Vrindavan, when we used to go in, I was allowed to go in Vrindavan in the evening time when Swami talks to the boy. So he used to tell me, wait, I'm calling the boys, I'll ask you to speak. I said, you ask me to speak, I'll never come again for your darshan. So if he said anything, I always had something to tell him. I said, if by chance you say, get up, no, I'm not going to speak. I never spoke when Swami was there. Yes, but before Swami took Samadhi, I think he had planned it. Everything was well planned by him. Just before he took Samadhi, I was supposed to go to Switzerland. So that time I said, oh my Lord, my host is not coming to pick me up at the airport. How will I go from Geneva to go all the way to Vevey? I said, how will I go? So Swami said, ask for the wheelchair and take the wheelchair. Because the airports of foreign countries are very, very huge. So I said, I am hatta katta, why will I take a wheelchair? He said, no, you take a wheelchair, they'll put you in the train. So well, from that, because Swami was actually training me. Because after Swami, I've gone a lot abroad and all. So he trained me that you don't get scared. I go alone every time. So then I arrange for a wheelchair. I have a polio certificate. So with the certificate, I'm given all the preference. But mind you, for income tax or for anything, I never use my certificate that I'm a disabled person. But for airport traveling, I do take the certificate and I get the wheelchair to go. Then I reached my host place, and this was before Swami's Mahasamadhi. It so happened that they made me talk in Geneva. That was my first talk in Geneva. Then I said, okay, we had simultaneously translation in French. And since I teach French, I could very well understand. So it was a very nice thing. Then little bit that fright went away. Then after that, they arranged in Amsterdam. I went there and I spoke. And that's how, before he went, he made me a speaker. And I have to thank two people in my life. Sister Yadlam from Bangalore, because she made me speak for Radio Sai Karnataka. And she told me, it's Swami's first anniversary, so you have so much of experience, you speak. So it was an emotional blackmail to me. I took it as that way. I said, no, I can't speak. I'm scared of this mic. So she said, don't worry, no one can see you. You speak and it will be translated in Kannada. So then I spoke and it was a grand success. Radio Sai Parthi called me and they said, you speak. So I spoke there. Then after speaking Radio Sai, then Radio Sai all over the world, everyone hears. So whenever I go to Europe nearly every alternate year and all that. So then when I went there, I was shocked. Paris had my talk in French. Italy has my talk in Italian. Germans had. So when they came to know I'm there, they would say, come and give a talk. So then I started. And then I realized my life took a U-turn. I am an industrialist. I was always working. I had a hot head. And I don't know, suddenly I took a U-turn and it's gone now all spiritual. But that was predicted to me by Swami. It was in 99, November 19th, Ladies' Day. Swami asked me, take Namaskar, go to Bangalore and start medical transcription. So I said, Swami, I don't know anything about medicine and all. I'm scared of an injection. I don't even take a tablet. So he says, no, nothing like that. You do this. You have too many doubts. I have to go around, take Namaskar and go to Bangalore. I said, I don't have money. He says, no, you go. So I went, 20th, I went to Bangalore. And suddenly my father's CA says, that Java, there is, for the ladies, KSFC is having loans. So why don't you ask your daughter to come? My father had applied for a loan for the ice cream company. They got only 15 lakhs. I went and it was Swami who was listening, answering all the questions. 32 people interviewed me. And after the interview, I got a chit 65. Now, I did not know the meaning of 65. It happened to be I was sanctioned a loan of 65 lakhs. This is between 19th and 23rd. So I was really shocked. I came home and everyone congratulating me. I said, why are you congratulating? I think this is not plain, ordinary paper. You have got a loan of 65 lakhs. I was really shocked. My father said, I am struggling. I got 15 lakhs and you got 65 lakhs. I said, I don't know. Then I came to Swami on 23rd. He said, start. I started. I was doing very well. My father was very, very happy. He saw that I was on the top. But I knew at the age of 50, I am not going to live longer. So I wanted to do this medical transcription, so I earned that much of money and I do in charity and do this and that. I had, you know, lot of dreams. So, but then what happened, I knew the time is very short. I was doing very well. Then one day my secretary came and I had wanted some signatures on the check for my mother. So she told me, Rani, I went to take signature but your mother cannot see. I said, but she's writing Om Sai Ram every day. She's saying, but you haven't seen, she's writing crooked. I was in the peak of my career. Where am I going to look at these small things? I went home, I saw. I said, Mom, you have lost your eyesight. You have not told me. She said, no, it's all right. You are coming up. I'm very happy. It took Daddy so many years to make a crore of rupee, but you are sitting and in 1 year, you can make 3 crores. So I'm very happy. Don't worry about me. I said, no. I gave up my industry. And I went into a very huge loss. But that was a learning step in of Swami. I lost 3 crores of rupees. I'm still alive in front of y'all. I didn't get a heart attack. I got nothing because I just thought, okay, it's all right. Money has come, money has gone, no problem. Swami on Ganesh Chaturthi day, he came to me and he made some signs. I didn't realize. I went back and the bank people called me and they said, congratulations, congratulations. I said, now what happened? They said, no, your loan, the chairman had come to the bank on Ganesh Chaturthi, and that is the time he looks at bad loans. So when he looked at my loan, he immediately said, oh my Lord, I have to meet this lady. So they called me. Then he told me, you know, every month I send to my parents 10,000 rupees. And I think I'm such a great soul. I'm sending 10,000 rupees to my parents. You're so highly educated. And you came to know your mother has lost her eyesight. You gave up your whole company and you went into a 3 crore loss. I said, sir, mother was more important than the business. So then he said, all your penalty, all your interest, everything is cancelled. You only pay the 65 lakhs. And I paid only 65 lakhs. I did not pay anything more and I could buy another house. It was Swami who helped me. You know, Swami comes to your help on the 99.9% because he's testing you to see how much faith you have. When I had to sell my flat, every stage in my life, every stage he has been looking after. Now, after Swami had taken Ma Samadhi, you know, it was my desire to be in teaching line. But my father never wanted me to be a teacher. So my first passport is that of a teacher. So he said, no, no, you have to join the industry. You have taken so much of education, you have to join the industry. So I joined him. But deep in my heart, I wanted to be a teacher. So Swami gave me an opportunity. I retired as a college principal, which I was very, very happy. I wanted to be a teacher, but I got a chance to be a principal. So I was very happy. He sees to every dream of mine. Because I only have him. I say, you are my everything. He says, yes, I am yours and you are mine. Whatever I dreamt in life, he got it fulfilled. I'm not at all, even though I lost everything, I got back everything. I always tell people when they lose all their wealth, they leave Swami. I'm so close to Swami and Swami did not take care of me and I lost everything. No. You lost because of your past life, because of your karmas. Please, have faith and determination. As a lady, it just took me 6 years to get back what I lost. You are a man, you can get much more and you can get it faster. Have faith in him, he will surely make it all right. If you all remember, in 1972, Swami had taken out the Jyotirling, and that time I had fought with my father and gone to Puttaparthi for Shivratri. And Swami had actually stopped Shivratri. I went, Swami's sisters fired me, why have you come? Swami no more has the Shivling. I said, no, I never got a chance to see, so I want to see it now. They said, but Swami is not here. We were in the bhajan hall singing bhajans and Swami comes from Vrindavan to Puttaparthi. And then he decides that he's going to do Shivratri. That is the time he materialized the Jyotirling. And the Jyotirling has the Jyoti inside and the different colors. So Swami comes down from the stage and he always made me sit right at the lady's side staircase because I have a problem in getting up and moving. So he came, he said, Pakoda, can you see the Jyoti? So I was going on looking. I said, where? Then he showed quite some time. I said, now I can see the Jyoti. Then he said, see the color changing. I said, yes, it is yellow. Then it's changing to blue. It's changing to green. He says, this is creation. Creation every second is changing. Then he took it around and he showed everyone. Then in the night he told me, Pakoda, you stand on the stage in this Punnachand auditorium and take care of the lingam that no one comes to the stage. So whole night I stood and I took care of the lingam. Morning Swami came, then he explained, you all had fights with your family and all. My father was feeling very, very guilty. Because I went by Madras mail, he refused to give me money. And those days the cheapest train was Madras mail. My friends gave me the money and we went to Parthi. So he was feeling very guilty. Since Swami said, all of them were saying, don't go. Swami is not having Shivratri. And see, y'all are the lucky few who are going to have this moksha. Then morning, those days Bhagavatam's son was there and he's also fat. So Jen side he and lady side me, we used to protect Swami to walk to the, to the interview room. Next day, Swami calls my father and me for an interview. and he says, Java, you like to have moksha? Because yesterday I declared. So my father said, no, Swami, I have few things which I have to do in the next birth. So I don't think I'm ready for moksha. Now I'm only 17 years old. And I can give you guarantee these are words of Swami in my mouth. He asked me, Pakoda, you want moksha? I did not know what is moksha because it was later on I attended the summer course. So I said, ha, Swami, if you say yes, too many difficulties. I have to clear all your past karmas. And you're there with me, no? Then he took his hand in his hand. He says, I am there with you. I will take care of you and I'll wash away all your karmas. And that which loss I had was my 50th birthday when my life was supposed to go. So Swami, I was dejected and he that time told me that I give you moksha. This is your last birth. So instead of dying at the age of 50, he told me you go to this Nadi fellow. So I said, Swami, I don't believe in Nadi fellows and all. He said, no, this man is very good, you go. So I went to Chamrajpet. I said, I don't have money, his fees may be very expensive. He said, don't worry, he will not take, only 500 rupees he will take. So I said, okay, I went. That man said that you have a halo of Swami around you. I said, okay, you have a very good Guruji and all that. I said, yes. Then he said, you know, you were supposed to die. I said, yeah, I knew from childhood that I'll die at the age of 50. Then he said, no. When Yama came to take you, Satya Sai told him that take her wealth and leave her for me. And then he told me that from now onwards, you will be leading a life which he has planned for you. And this is what he planned, because from 2002, I have started talking and giving my experience. And let me tell you, it's not me talking. It is he who is talking. Because as I said, I'm not a speaker. I don't know how to speak. And I'm still scared of this. I'm not very happy with this. But I leave it to him. Whatever he decides has to come out, comes out. Because my life is an open book and there are experiences and experiences and experiences. But whatever he desires, it comes. And I think I've taken quite a lot of time of yours. I'm so sorry, all of y'all. But once I get into Swami and his leelas and his love, I get carried away and I talk too much. And I need to say one thing, which I always tell my brothers and sisters of the foreign country, that please, please come to Puttaparthi. Come to the Samadhi. Now you'll say, why? You know, Swami used to always tell me that, I should say, Swami, we are sitting for four hours for you, leg pain and everything. He said, don't worry, one day I'll be waiting for you. Today y'all are waiting for me, one day I'll be waiting. So he's waiting for you people. You know, the days when Swami was there, when he was walking around, all those molecules used to go right around. So we used to get a small speck and we used to all grumble, you know, all the VIPs are sitting in the front and we used to feel all that is going to them. But we also used to get a small, small molecule of it. But today, all that power is in that Samadhi. So when your head touches that Samadhi, you are getting a direct contact of that power. Why do we go to Shirdi? Why? I still go to Shirdi. I go every year to Shirdi because I still have ties with Shirdi. It's because we feel that the Samadhi has got a lot of powers. Same way, Parthi Samadhi has got a lot and lot of powers. You all will be really surprised. I spend 15 days in Parthi. I am a teacher. I teach and I immediately in the evening I take the car and go to Parthi. Before my next class, I come back. So I spend 5 days there, come back. I keep moving up and down because I feel he's very much there. And today he's waiting for us. We are not waiting. What tapasya we did, waiting for 5 hours, going at 5 o'clock in the morning, and Swami comes at 7 and sometimes he doesn't come. So with all the tapasya what we have done, today is the time you enjoy the fruits of your tapasya which you did that time. You go and you touch your head on the Samadhi, but pray properly. Use the correct words. Every word you use has to be framed very well, because exactly as you say, he does. So if you have framed the sentence wrongly, be sure you're going to get it the wrong way. But be precise, be positive, and tell him that this is the thing I want. And you see, I can tell you, he will surely do it for you. Be whatever it is, Swami will listen to you. And always have the inner talk with him. He is in you. You and he are one. Everyone is one. See Swami in everyone and you will feel happy. You will never ever feel sad. I live alone. I am always living alone. But I have all around Swami and I am very happy. You will never see me like, oh my Lord, oh my Lord. No, there is no oh my Lord, oh my Lord. We both joke. We have fun. And I tell Swami, I went through bad times, you went through bad times. You did not get those things to eat, I did not get those things to eat. So we share. If I get happiness, you have happiness. If I have sorrow, you have sorrow. So you take it that way. Don't take him separate. Take him as one with you. And you see how much of happiness and pleasures you all will get. Jai Sai Ram, all of you. Thank you for being ardent listeners. Oh, I'm told I can talk another 10-15 minutes. Are you all ready? If you will notice, Swami is very possessive of his devotees. Very, very possessive. For him, we are all his. You may put him on a pedestal, but no, he looks at all of us in the same way. And you won't believe, I used to always tell, my father used to get angry with me because I had a habit of arguing with Swami. I could argue with him because he has brought me up and he has been my friend. So my father used to say, no, 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 he is God. If he tells, Swami will say, Java, is it evening? We are in Vrindavan. And it's nice, we are come out from the darshan. It's morning. He'll ask, Java, is it evening? And my father, huh, Swami, it is evening. And I'll open my big fat mouth. No, Swami, we just came from darshan. It is morning. We have to still have lunch. My daddy will keep shouting. Don't say that way. You don't know. He will change it into night. He's God. I said, but he's saying something wrong. He's saying it is night, it is afternoon, it's morning, we have to still eat lunch. Then Swami used to tell my father, Java, don't. She has a right to argue with me. I had a good right to argue with Swami. And he really, and I had the plus point of Ishwarama's blessings and love. Because if Swami got upset or anything, it was very simple. Go to Amma, tell her that he has shouted at me. He gets it back and I am free. So I never had a problem. Amma took so much care of me. My first sari also she put it for me. Everything she did. So in summer course when Amma passed away, I wanted to go to Puttaparthi. No, you don't go. You be here. You attend the classes. So I attended the classes. But what is the role of a woman and how strong a woman has to be? I learned that from Ishwar Amma. Because still then, I always thought that I was a weaker person because in our India, we are told that girls are nothing. They are pauki juti and they are this and they are that. But girl has no equality with men. So I always thought, oh, I'm handicapped. I'm no use. I'm useless. But it was Amma who taught me, no, you are not useless. You are the one who is going to take care of everything. And then I recognized my character, my instincts, and then I decided, no, I am something. And I am going to become something. And that's how I proved myself by having all that education and everything. And I stood up in life and I'm fully independent. And that is only thanks to Ishwar Amma and no one else. Because she brought out that thing in me and she said, women are the force. No man can live and survive without the help of a woman. So don't think yourself, because I used to always think I'm handicapped and all, I'm such a useless person to society, to my family, to my parents. But after that, after 1968, I decided nothing doing, I have to come up in life, and I came up in life. Amma was a very, very strong person. Very, very strong person. though we did not know Telugu, we had a translator who used to translate to us and we used to converse. And then it's a heart language, you make signs and you talk and all that. It so happened that in Bombay, from Chembur, one of the aunties taught us to write and speak Telugu. So I thought that I'm going for so many years, I should also learn to speak Telugu. So with the help of that auntie, I wrote a letter to Swami. And you know what he did? In Vrindavan, inside over there, in front of all the people sitting, he made fun of my letter. Because, you know, the curves went wrong and all that. So he made fun of me. And then everyone was laughing and I felt so bad, so hurt, that till date I never spoke Telugu. Every time Swami said, no, learn, no, one mistake. I said, why did you? You could have called me separately and told me that this is your mistake. In front of the gathering over there, you tell me that I've done that. So whenever I go now, Janaki Ram's wife, Meenatai, anyone, they always ask me, huh, they'll talk in Telugu. I said, no, still Hindi, no Telugu. They said, but why? I said, he insulted me in front of the whole public. I cannot learn to speak Telugu. I have never learned Telugu. Yes, I understand Telugu, but I don't speak Telugu. I can just understand a little bit. And mind you, no one in my family, in my friend circle or anyone knew that I was a Sindhi. Everyone thought that I am an Andhra person because dressing always like a Andhraite and all that with flowers in your hair and all that stuff. So I just... I was telling you all about that moksha, no? So Swami said, you were with me in Shirdi Sai, then you will be, you're there now with Parthi Sai. Then you all remember in the olden days that Shirdi Ma with the big butti was there? So he said, you will be like her, you'll be wearing a big butti and you will have my darshan as Prema Sai. So he blessed me, and when his mother Kasturi was born, that time his parents had brought him, that baby, to Prashanti Nilayam. Swami told me, go see, your friend has come. So as baby Kasturi, I have seen Swami's mother. I was very fortunate to see Swami there. And there's one other incident which I would like to say, you know, Swami used to go by the flight and all, and Daddy used to arrange everything. My brother, my sister, everyone has traveled in the flight with Swami. But I have not traveled in the flight with Swami. So I told Swami, Swami, everyone has gone in the flight with you. Why not me? Why partiality with me? He said, no, you go ahead to Bangalore and you receive me at the plane. I will come with Daddy in the plane. You receive me at the aircraft. So I said, okay. Then I said, but still one time only let me travel with you. Then so sweetly he said, no. When you will leave this body, I will come with the plane to take you to heaven. And that was the gift which I am really, really grateful and happy. After that, I never asked him, Swami, why aren't you taking me in the plane? Because I know that when I leave this body, he will take me with him. He said, I'll come and take you in my van. So this is how I spent my childhood and everything with Swami. A very, very pleasant, and it was like, it's, for me, it's like reliving every moment with him. And I don't know if I managed to give you all that happiness and all that. And his love and his leela, I just wanted to just share with all of you all.